KDF Ahua. KDF Ahua. Your Excellency, yesterday gave you a slight brief on what Mzee would have wanted. And today when we're picking him up from the morgue, I'm glad your direction for merging the military and our wishes have been respected. Mzee lying over here, the casket he's lying in, is a very simple mbao ambayo hata haijapigwa randa. It's very rough. I've just been told it actually costed 6,800 shillings. Hii mambo mingi ya casket ati mtu mkubwa 500,000, 1 million. His essence and spirit is no longer with us. This is a body which he served the country with, and now it is finished. Yeah, in addition to that, let me just briefly address the rumors I've been seeing on social media asking, is this guy, was he Muslim? The rights he wants to be buried with, what's happening? Your Excellency, as you know, Jesus himself, how he was buried. He was wrapped in a sheet and put in a tomb. Right now, Mzee is wearing the uniform he donned for number one functions, but tomorrow we'll be wrapping him in the sheets, we'll extract him from the casket and lay him in the ground so that he can return to us dust as quickly as possible, just the way he wanted it, and just following the man he admired the most, Jesus Christ. Your Excellency, my father always alikuwa na mambo matatu kama wewe, not the same, but all his speeches were divided into three. Today I divided it into four because he was a foster general. Firstly, you heard from Bishop Lele about his love for God. Somewhere in that helicopter wreck is his Bible, which was his most precious possession. Anyone who worked with him in DHQ, MAB, LAB, wherever, can attest that he always had a Bible with him. And I am hoping they're able to retrieve it from the accident. I'd want to keep it as a memento, and for the rest of the family as well. His Bible meant a lot to him, and between me and him, the rest of the family, my mom and my wife were a bit slow, but we'd always engage in a competition for reading the Bible and discuss the mortality and all these things of life. He understood that his position was temporary and it would always end. Leading up to his death, he almost knew that his time was up. Despite having very many plans for the military and for his family, but he spoke in a certain tone that would suggest that, my son, I won't always be here, and you will need to take care of my wife and my other children, which I am more than ready to do, and it will not be a problem. And Matthew 5:3, Beatitudes of Jesus, it says that blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. He was the poorest man in spirit. Easy chase cars mingi, ofisi kubwa, watu kumuita CDF, general, sir. To him it was all vanity. It was a necessary thing for him to be able to fulfill his job, nothing more. As he lays here with his uniform, I see they put his medals, his sword and boots. He loved it as a tool for the job, but nothing more. Don't be under any illusion that he thinks is important once he breathed his last. That was point number one, his love for God. His point number two and point number three is a very blurry line. It is about his soldiers and his family. I can guarantee you right now, ule private mwenye amekaa pale juu kwa kona and me, he viewed us almost the same. You may not have had the same privileges I might have had being his son, but in his heart of hearts, the lowest person, the cleaner, to his vice, he treated all of them with respect. And he respected every single human life. His worst days was when he had or rather different days he hears his soldiers have been hit. He was actually mourning like he was mourning a child. And he'd go down to his knees and ask, God, what is happening here? Hard for me strength. Naitaji kulima hii altabau kabisa. Naitaji kulima hii bandits kabisa. Which is what he was doing in the line of duty when he went down. And I want to tell even the bandits or Al-Shabaab who are celebrating, mtu mwenye alikuwa na lima lima kila wakati, muongeze click. Watu ya SF, mukipewa mission ya kwenda kulima adui, maliza kabisa. Na ukifanya skirmishing, confirm. Muongeze tatu za kichwa. That's how he would have wanted it. He wanted to die, in fact, fighting one of these enemies. And so, musikubali kuogopa Al-Shabaab. Kama mdosi wenyu hako anaogopa adui, basi mnaogopa nini? Si yeye amelala hapa, na sisi wote tutalala hapa. Usipende maisha yako yote sana, na iko kitu moja kubwa kushinda wewe, Mwenyezi Mungu na nchi yetu ya Kenya. Lima Al-Shabaab, lima musiangushe click. Muongeze, muongeze, muongeze. Watu ya Boni, endeleeni kuongeza.
This is the Nairobi Fame TV, where we bring you the latest, trending and urban news in Nairobi, Kenya and from around the world. Subscribe and stay tuned for more.